Your Majesty, Your Excellency, Mr. Helle Thorning-Schmidt, Prime Minister of Denmark, Your Excellency, Mr. Willy Schundam, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Your Excellency, Mr. Christian Fries Bach, Minister for Development Cooperation, Your Honorable Mr. Frank Jensen, Lord Mayor of Copenhagen, Excellencies, members of Diplomatic Corps, honorable and distinguished guests, dear colleagues of the United Nations, ladies and gentlemen. I am honored and delighted to join with all of you for the official opening of this magnificent new home for the United Nations in Denmark. I thank the government and the people of Denmark for their generous investment and long-standing support for the United Nations. This is a beautiful and inspiring complex. It's a concrete symbol of your commitment to the United Nations. And it is an important contribution towards a more efficient and carbon-neutral United Nations. Addressing climate change is a responsibility for all. And I am determined that the UN should walk the walk. In New York, the Capitol Master Plan renovations will reduce energy consumption by 50%. The new additions to the United Nations headquarters in Nairobi are an example of eco-friendly architecture fitted to the local environment. And throughout the United Nations system, from peacekeeping to paper saving, we are working on greening the blue. This building is quite literally a shining example. In 2011, I had the honor of opening this UNICEF warehouse at Campus 2. Today, I'm privileged to witness the culmination of your vision of a cutting-edge, environmentally friendly hub for United Nations operations. As I look up at this stunning staircase, and when I walk through these light-filled corridors and spacious meeting rooms and halls, I cannot help but feel my spirit highly lifted, as you are. From the rows of parked bicycles to the wind turbines out to sea, I see proof that we can tackle the climate changes that face us. From solar panels to seawater cooling and external metal blinds to regulate light and heat, UN City Copenhagen shows what can be achieved. Estimated energy consumption will be cut by more than half. UN City is an example of how modern energy-efficient offices can play their part in building the future we want. But it is what happens inside these buildings and the change it can make around the world that is most important. Once complete, UN City Copenhagen will house around 1,200 personnel from 8 United Nations organizations, providing support to crucial humanitarian, peace-building, and development operations around the world. Bringing so many UN organizations together in one location allows for shared logistics, administration, networking, and collegiality, enhancing cooperation and ability to deliver as one. The work done here makes a real difference to the lives of the poor and vulnerable around the world. Denmark should be rightly proud of its contribution. Denmark is also one of the handful of countries to meet the United Nations target of devoting at least 0.7% of gross national income to official development assistance. I know Denmark is now reaching 1% point soon, and congratulations. Indeed, Denmark has met and often exceeded that target for an incredible 35 years. That's since 1978, the year when Anker Jorgensen led a grand coalition as prime minister, and when Jimmy Carter brokered Middle East peace process with the Camp David Accords. Just to give you some perspective of 1978 was also the year when the world music charts were topped by the Bee Gees with the Staying Alive. ABBA with the Take a Chance on Me, and John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John with You Are the One That Won. Now, after 35 years of Danish leadership, helping children around the world not only stay alive, but also thrive, I'm proud to say that Denmark has always been a partner worth taking a chance on, and you are most certainly the one that we want. Simply put, Denmark delivers. UN City is one more example. This is a place where very good things are happening, and where even more and will be done. This year, Denmark is celebrating the bicentennial of the philosopher Søren Kierkegaard. Kierkegaard said, and I quote, "If I were to wish for anything, I should not wish for wealth and power, but for the passionate sense of potential, for the eye which, ever young and ardent, sees the possible," end of quote. This new campus and activities happening in it show the world what is possible. I thank Your Majesty, Your Prime Minister, Your Excellency and the ministers and government and people of Denmark for this outstanding investment and support, generous support and contribution in the United Nations and in humanity. Thank you.